We all watched in horror as planes crashed into the steel and glass of the World Trade Center.
That is the World Trade Center, and we have unconfirmed reports this morning that a plane...
I saw the plane hit the building. It's got to be a terrorist attack.
Move out of the way! Let's go! Hey, come on!
Now we are not afraid, although we know there's much to fear. We were moving mountains long before we knew we could.
The plane was coming in. I noticed it a second before it hit the building. It looked like it was moving slowly, and it lined itself up to hit the building directly.
The doorman goes to me, wow, I never seen a plane flying so low. And we looked out at it, all of a sudden, boom, it seemed like it wasn't even real.
And then about a half hour later, a second plane.
It was unbelievable seeing this second jet come crashing into the second tower. What is going on?
When you believe, somehow you will.
Not appear that there's any kind of an effort up there yet. Now remember, oh my God.
That looks like a second plane.
Okay, there's been an explosion of some kind that shook the grounds of the Capitol. We all heard it. Everybody ran for cover. We don't know where it was. We don't see the smoke yet. Everybody's hanging back. We're running. They're screaming at us to get the
out. Why are they pulling us out of here?
Because the main tower is leaning.
The north tower is leaning.
Oh my God, there it goes!
We're facing a new kind of enemy. We're involved in a new kind of warfare, and we need the help of the Spirit of God.
Witnesses reported seeing the large passenger plane take a nosedive.
We are at threat condition Delta. That is the highest condition that we can go to.
Make no mistake, the United States will hunt down and punish those responsible for these cowardly acts.
God is our refuge and strength, an ever-present help in trouble. Therefore, we will not fear, though the earth give way and the mountains fall into the heart of the sea.
Tonight, I ask for your prayers for all those who grieve, for the children whose worlds have been shattered, for all whose sense of safety and security has been threatened. And I pray they will be comforted by a power greater than any of us, spoken through the ages in Psalm 23. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I fear no evil, for you are with me. This is a day when all Americans from every walk of life unite in our resolve for justice and peace. America has stood down enemies before, and we will do so this time. None of us will ever forget this day. Yet we go forward to defend freedom and all that is good and just in our world. Thank you, and God bless America.
Those buildings eventually plummeted to the ground, imploding it upon themselves. Yet underneath the debris is a foundation that was not destroyed. Yes, our nation has been attacked, buildings destroyed, lives lost. But now we have a choice, whether to implode and disintegrate emotionally and spiritually as a people and a nation, or whether we choose to become stronger through all of this struggle to rebuild on a solid foundation.